previously on Action.
You could be an atheist and you should still be against sorcery accusation violence, because this is an atrocity. This is a crime against humanity.
We have to do absolutely everything to finish any form of violence, especially sorcery-related violence.
Hi, I'm Hejron Wangi Jr. Thank you for joining me on Action. Action is a series that explores the complex problem of sorcery accusation-related violence in Papua New Guinea. This mainly involves the belief in sorcery, the violence that arises out of that belief, and the people involved. For our feature story, we will hear from Sister Lorena Janal, a Franciscan sister of Divine Providence who is part of the Diocese of Mende and has been working for years to bring peace in that province.
Talking about sorcery-related violence is one thing, but witnessing it with your own eyes is an experience that is likely to change you forever. This is exactly what happened to Sister Lorena when she first came across this atrocity that has become so rampant in our country.
It was almost exactly 5 years ago. It was before Christmas. I came in September back from Switzerland after a longer break. That time I didn't even know that it would be getting so heavily involved with sorcery-related cases. I was just admiring the beauty on my way up to Nipa. I was actually driving from here towards Upper Plateau, going into the Semin Road, and they stopped me at the road, and a big group of people were there and said, "Could you sit with us? We have a terrible news to tell you." Up at the Upper Plateau, very close to Tegefo, they accused a young mother with her 16 or 15-year-old girl to be a sorcerer. For 2 days, the people heard them crying, being buried alive. Right there on the spot, I said, "If you like me to stay here, all of you have to help me to make a promise. That's the first and the last time that this will happen."
I'm going to go to the house.
Morning.
Like many other victims of sorcery-related violence, Maria was falsely accused by a woman from her own village of having practiced sorcery, something that she never did, but was almost murdered for it.
One blame Maria me go ethical psychosis. I'm calling name blame Maria one them. Me to bla exchange ego come the private part blame not bla ego come na me psychosis. I'm rousing tintin blame. In this bla gan talk is enough strong one them this la Mary. Now only talk. Me bla a suspect. You want bla sanguma. So cooking me. No, 8 o'clock morning, go finish me nap. 6 o'clock avenue, dark. Me con blow hand blow fire warrant na marijuana. Na only cooking me. Na only not releasing me. They're killing me.
Fortunately for Maria, one of her sons came to her rescue. But it was through the help of Sister Lorena that she was able to be released and moved into a safe house, away from her own community.
Now le carry me go down lo come in. One blay come as a helper. One kind of a member helping me, putting me go to bed, helping me give me kai kai, helping me go wash me in this black and Sister Lorena come up. And Mr. Pigo want them all, Pigo. Almost 4 months. 4 months in jail, Lord, 4 months. And feeding me one them spoon, me open mouth, that's all. Me open mouth, I'm setting water, me talk me hungry, lo water. Me open mouth, and put him spoon, kai kai. Me talk me hungry, lo kai kai. Now, me is like go at it, small house, hard. Put him lo bucket. Me helping me, lo, go through my tooth.
In 2017, when Maria was almost dying, she was so bad that we couldn't put the IV into her veins any longer. And since then, I have been able to save 140 women. 14 died on me, one in my own lap. I'm still holding her, trying to save her, and she passed away in my arms. And I'm still crying, and I'm still going to her grave. The first week when they are with us, we invite their family members to come and visit. That's always the first thing. With Maria, she had no visit from any members of her family for 2 months, two entire months. Actually, with each survivor, it's a big struggle. Because there is the fear and there is the torture that will follow all our survivors till they die. That fear that they will be harmed again, that they will be blamed again. And therefore the integration starts from the very moment they come to us.
Thanks to her exceptional work, Sister Lorena was able to attract the attention of the international community and was awarded with a human rights prize to finally build a safe house for the many victims of sorcery-related violence.
On that 10th of December, when I received the prize for the human rights, I decided that the House of Hope will be started with the prize and with the help I got from all these friends of mine and all these network people who worked since then with me. We will not call it what everybody else calls it, because the House of Hope is giving a voice to women. It's giving rights to women. It's giving hope to women, and it's integrating women again.
They named them Maria, Joseph, and Mary. Oh,
okay. My name is Linda, and it's my husband, Aruna. We are, in fact, from here, I'm from Germany. Aruna comes from West Africa, from the Ivory Coast. So we got married last year, and now we are currently based here at the House of Hope. For me, I'm a social worker, and I'm assisting Sister Lorena in all she's doing. Because of the three and a half months, roughly, we are here. We have gone through very many different experiences, also very hard and difficult ones. But what we know is that this house is really life-saving. We know that many women would be dead by now if this house and this project of Sister Lorena would not be here. And so it's like very, very amazing to see how the women find their spirits again. And we are really hopeful that this House of Hope is changing something.
To unite the church, one local, and one Muslim, and two Catholics. We are accepting, we don't ask for denomination, like the lady who was a Muslim. Yeah, that's why we use it. And also,
first of all, we restore them physically. And our very, very first thing that's uppermost in our mind is that the women, when they come here, there will be no shouting, no violence, no tension. And you know that it's natural when women are, anyhow, even in the best relationship between a married couple, they are conflicts, they are different ideas, they are different opinions. That's normal and that's healthy. And we provide that too, that there is enough. But peace has to be at the center of everything.
Workshop and access to justice.
Every afternoon we have a lesson on justice and human rights, just to make sure that every single woman knows I have a name, I have dignity, I have talents, I have rights.
Most of the time we sit outside. We have seen incredible violence also just within these 3 months. And I think this is something which needs to start in the families with the small kids. We are trying step by step to bring change.
Pour moi, le problème commence depuis le bas âge. C'est un problème d'éducation. Et ils grandissent avec un sentiment de violence qu'ils ont vu peut-être chez leurs parents, qui faisaient la violence peut-être à leur mère ou à quelque chose. Et ils grandissent avec. Pour moi, je voudrais mettre une base sur l'éducation. Ça doit commencer depuis le bas âge. Il faut éduquer les enfants contre la violence. Et aussi respecter les femmes. Elle a toujours son mot à dire.
Last week, when we integrated these three women. We had the most horrifying experience. I went out there for the third time, and every time I thought, I'm not going back, because the road cannot even imagine. And then we ended with one tire completely between the bridge, and it took us ages to get that. And honestly, I was afraid. And I'm not many times afraid, but on Friday I was afraid that we'll never make it. So you see, sometimes the impossible becomes possible, and that's why networking and working with the communities and with the family and with the law and with the magistrate is so terribly important. Otherwise, we don't make it.
Hi, my name is Zaria, and I'm part of the Clean Generation, a movement of young people all across Papua New Guinea who are taking a stand to build a nation that is strong and safe. And it is important for us to take a stand against sorcery accusation-related violence. You have seen people at the front line, heard their stories, and seen the impact of this violence. Young people are saying enough is enough, and that this violence has to end.
Coming up in the next episode of Action.
There was a body that had been left in the morgue in Mount Hagen. That body was the body of Kapari Lenyetta, a woman who was tortured and murdered in 2013. And not only that, her entire community abandoned her.
Government must banish Sambla Rodlo. Straight him, or Emla Wokim Sambla and banish Flungemlo. Look out him on this blood, evil spirit, me blow him and give him all law. All must Wokim Sambla and we only know what was saying by killing it.
It's a horrific spectacle that can last for days. Yeah, and that's one of the changes that's come about in recent times.